Okay, you can open up this folder. And in this folder, you have a reference sheet that I got from your textbook. Okay? And this reference sheet basically tells you all how to classify triangles by sides and angles, and you should already know that, but if you need help, you can go back to this page. And on the back is how to classify quadrilaterals. Okay? And so this is just for you to help you with this next activity that you're going to do. Okay? So there's one for each of you in there. And then there is a group task card in here. Okay, if you look at that card, we already did number one. Can somebody read number two to me, please? Loud and clear so that everybody can see it. So, and everybody should read number two on the group task card. Everybody find the group task card? Luis, did you find the group task card?
Yeah.
Looks like this. Okay. I'll put it up here so you can see it. Okay, can somebody, we already did number one. We already did sort shapes in a way that makes sense to you. Okay, somebody read number two to me. Luis, read it really loud, please.
Make a tree map poster with the polygons and organize polygons in tree map. Think of a way to organize the polygons and classify them. Please trace the shapes on the poster and label the shapes. Also include the properties of each shape.
Okay, so somebody tell me in their own words, what are we doing right now? Yeah, I know the phone was ringing, it was kind of distracting there. Marissa, tell me what you're going to do.
We're making a tree map with the polygons and classify and write the properties.
And write the properties, okay. So you're going to make a tree map. I'm going to give you a big piece of paper. Big piece of paper. This is going to be a big tree map. Okay. Alright. Because you're going to need a lot of space. Okay, and so you're going to make a tree map. What's going to be on the top of your tree map? What? Polygons, right? And then you're going to have how many groups? Some of you already did this in your last sort. How many groups are you going to have, basically? Saul? You're probably going to have about five groups, unless you sort them in another way. But if you sort them the way you just did, probably about five groups. Okay, and then you're going to put them on the poster, and then what, Janice?
You're going to trace them.
You're going to trace them. Good. You're going to trace them. And what else? What else? Yes, Tatiana. Label the shape. Tell me what kind of shape it is. And? Yes.
And include the properties of the shape.
And put the properties of each of the shapes. Very nice, very nice. A suggestion to you. Before you trace the shape, okay, make sure all the shapes are on here and you have them already grouped. And then as you trace the shape, take it off and put it back in the bag. Okay? Alright, everybody understand that part? Hey, the only reason I do that is because I don't want you to get confused. Did I already trace that one? Did I not trace it? So, and the last thing I want you to read to me is the group norms. Those are important because we're going to work in a group here. Somebody read the group norms to me. Jeffrey.
All students must participate.
Okay, keep going.
To each other. Nobody is done until everybody is done. Help each other and respect.
Good. Okay. Everybody needs to participate. Okay. You need to listen to each other. Okay. If somebody wants to put a shape in a different place, listen and talk it out. Okay. Nobody's done until everybody's done. You got to work as a team. Because if we don't work as a team, we're not going to finish. It's a big task. Okay. So everybody understand what they have to do. All right. So I'm going to go ahead and give you your paper. It's probably going to cover up your shapes, so you might want to get your shapes out of the way so I can put the paper Okay? On your desk. Each shape is going to have different properties, like a right triangle. I mean, you can put the properties in general what a triangle is, but then when you put the other triangle, maybe you get more specific to that shape.
Like, what about the Pentagon?
Pentagon is pretty much, what are you going to say? That's all we can say, right? Unless you want to measure the angles, then you can put how much each, all the angles are, total of angles of a pentagon. Okay, but I want to make sure everybody's working, everybody's in this team, you got to work group together, okay? I would say this way.
This way?
Yeah. So polygons, and then your lines, and then you group 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and then the shapes. Huh? Yeah, but before you trace, make sure you put them all there. Yeah. Huh? Yeah. No, those are not going to be on there because they're not polygons.
Yeah, I thought.
I
would like the isosceles and.
Yes. Yeah, I like that. Yeah. Okay. Okay, can I have your attention, please? Can we all sit down? Leave your poster the way you are right now. You're working. We're going to finish it, but we may not have time to finish it today. But just kind of leave it there, and I want to kind of get to the discussion part, because that's the important part right now. Okay, I want to hear your plans and how you're doing your poster and how you're sorting your polygons and why it makes sense to you. So can we all stop working for a little bit? Jeffrey, have a seat, please. Thank you. All right. So is there a group that wants to kind of share what they're doing? Kennedy, what are you guys doing?
So we're separating our polygons by the sides and the triangles.
Okay, time out. Wait, are we ready over here? We ready? Okay, let's start again. Sorry about that.
We're separating our polygons by sides, and the triangles are being sorted by sides and angles. The quadrilaterals are being separated by rhombuses.
Okay. All right, so I have all the shapes up here. Can you come and show me up here how you are classifying the triangles? Okay. If a couple of you from the group want to come up and show me that, I have all the triangles right here. Show us how you're classifying them, and I'm gonna kind of put this up so that you guys can, that we can get as much of you of the table as possible. All right, there you go. Okay, and I'm gonna want another group to kind of show me how you classified the quadrilaterals. So be thinking if you want to be that group. Okay, you need to talk to them and talk louder, please, Tatiana.
And this category, we put the scaling triangles with the right angle. We put the right triangle.
Can you tell me why? Tell us why you did that. Can somebody else from the group want to jump in and tell us why? Jocelyn?
Because the angle, the lateral, the top left has three equal sides.
Okay. So are you classifying them by sides? Is that what you're telling me? One of them has equal, all of them equal, so it's equilateral. The other one has two equal, what is it called? What do you call a triangle that has two equal sides? Anybody help her? JP? Isosceles, and one that has none equal sides?
Scalene.
Do we see those up here? Do we see an equilateral? Do we see an isosceles? Do we see a scalene? Are they up here? Okay, show me the equilateral one. Where is the isosceles? And where is the scalene? Which one?
Those two.
Oh, those two are scalene. Okay, good. Now, classifying them by angles, what are the types of triangles we'd have? If we try classifying by angles, Saul? Acute triangle. What else? Obtuse triangle. And right triangle. Are those up here? Yeah, can you show me the right triangle? Okay, is this a right triangle?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Yes? I disagree with you guys.
It's tilted.
I see, is this a 90 degree angle?
Yes.
Yes? Oh, it's just tilted?
Mm-hmm. It's tilted.
Oh, okay. Maybe it is. Okay, now I see it. The top one, you don't think this top one is a right angle? Okay, about 80, 85, maybe 89. Okay. All right. Do we see an obtuse triangle up there? You see an obtuse, Emily?
I'm not really sure, but I think it's the bottom middle one.
That one's not obtuse.
You think that's obtuse?
No, if you turn it, it's right.
No. It's a right triangle.
That's a right. Okay. I didn't find an obtuse either. So I asked some of the groups to actually draw it. Okay. All right, good. Give them a hand. Is there a group that wants to share how they did their quadrilaterals? Jeffrey's group, come up here. There's a lot of quadrilaterals, so. Here are the quadrilaterals. And as they're doing the quadrilaterals, can somebody tell me how they did the pentagons? What did they do with the pentagons? Somebody tell me what you do. Jacqueline, what did you guys do with the pentagon?
For the pentagon, we divided them by how many sides it had and how many.
They all have what? They all have five sides. Did anybody sort those in a special way, or they just basically put all the pentagons together? You put them together? Anybody, you sorted them already?
Yeah.
All right, tell us about your sort.
We sorted them by their type.
Okay.
So we had the parallelograms here, and there was only one longest, and it kind of looked like a parallelogram.
Okay.
But we put it in rhombus.
All right. Can you turn around and talk to them?
And then we also put, we also did the trapezoids and then we put the ones that didn't really have a category actually.
Okay. What do you mean by they didn't have a category?
They didn't match any of the properties of
the other parallelogram square. Okay. So those are just quadrilaterals. Okay. All right. Oscar, can you tell us a little bit more what you guys did?
Well, we tried to put them together as how they would normally be together, like rectangles would be together with squares.
Okay. Are there some quadrilaterals there that can be put in another group?
Yeah, so I think it would be...
It would be this one.
Okay, let Oscar tell us, please.
Square can be a rectangle, but a rectangle can be a square.
Okay, so a square can go into the rectangle group. Okay, can a square go on any other group?
It can go into a rhombus.
Into a rhombus, yeah. Okay, and where else could it go?
Parallelogram.
Parallelogram, good. All right. Eduardo, can you tell us about trapezoids? Can you show me on one of those trapezoids the two lines that are parallel? Okay, good. Good job. Good. Michaela, can you tell us about the parallelograms? I know they're a little high there for you, but... Okay, can you come and show us over here where they're at? Can you show us the two pairs? Those two and which other two? Good. Good job. So, all right. And they all have, all their angles add up to what?
To 300.
For all of them, right?
Yeah.
Even these right here.
Yeah.
Okay, because they're quadrilaterals. So we know that quadrilaterals, the sum of angles equals 360. Okay, good job. Give them a hand. Okay.